News coming in from Bengaluru. The Income Tax Department is conducting raids on the residence of former Union Minister and former Karnataka Chief Minister. He is also former Union Foreign Affairs Minister, SM Krishna's son-in-law Siddhartha. The raids are being conducted on all properties of Siddhartha, including Way to Wealth, Serial Estates, Cafe Coffee Day. The raids are underway at over 20 locations in Bengaluru, Mumbai, Chennai and Chikmagalur. Krishna had recently quit the Congress and joined Bharatiya Janata Party. And this is a serious problem from SM Krishna, though SM Krishna wouldn't have made much difference to the fortunes of Bharatiya Janata Party. But the fact that the son-in-law of the former Foreign Affairs Minister, who is also a business tycoon, to get raided like this is a sign of a serious trouble. And I'm joined by Nishchita on phone line. Nishchita, what reason and what is the issue which prompted the raids?
Well, as of now, there is no clarity on what exactly prompted the raid, but has come as a rather surprise. VG Siddhartha had recently gone public with his Coffee Day company, and as per market reports, it had not done as well as expected. So his company is already in doldrums, is what is being stated. The prices of the shares dipped from what they had started off in the market. And now we understand that multiple locations are being raided. It's in Bengaluru, his residence, as well as his Coffee Day main office, which is on the plush Vittal Malaya Road, is being raided. His estates in Chikmagalur are being raided. His offices in Chennai, Coimbatore and several other parts of the country are also being raided by the IT officials. Let's also not forget that in the just a few months back, SM Krishna, who is widely credited for the IT boom in Bengaluru when he was the chief minister, made the shift from Congress to the BJP. He was expected to bring in all his support, and he was expected to bring in that extra force, especially when the party went into bipoles in Nanjangud as well as Gundlupet. And both the elections, the BJP lost out to the Congress, both the bipoles. So SM Krishna, to a large extent, has been looked at as a spent force. So will this have an impact on his political career? What is the reason that VG Siddhartha has been raided? We are still awaiting details. The raid started at around 8:30 in the morning, Kartikeya, and so far, nothing substantial has really come out of the raid.
You be with me, but to describe it to the viewers, Mr. Siddhartha owns Cafe Coffee Day. It's the biggest coffee chain in India. It's like a household name. And it was part and parcel of that mini revolution where coffee was introduced to North India as something which could be made available on a day-to-day basis. Because in India, you know, the coffee and the filter coffee was associated with the culture in the South, but not in the North. So, you know, he was part and parcel of that reform wave which took place in India. Secondly, there were the other enterprises to which he was linked to. Now, Nishchita, isn't it surprising that Mr. Krishna joins BJP 3 months later, raids happening when it was least expected that something on him would happen?
Without a doubt, irrespective of the fact that all such bodies like IT or CBI are supposed to be independent, in our country, the moment a raid happens, we immediately bring political affiliations to it. Case in point being DK Shivkumar's raid a few months back. He was a sitting minister. It happened when the Gujarat MLAs were in Bengaluru, and the immediate assumption that was drawn was that it was political vendetta, or the IT raids were not entirely an independent move by the department. But what is the reason now is the big question that is being raised. Answers are very few at the moment. SM Krishna made the big shift to the BJP. SM Krishna's face is on many posters across Bengaluru ahead of the elections, and the BJP is also banking on him to bring in the young urban voters, because he has been largely credited for the IT boom in the city of Bengaluru, for making Bengaluru the way it is. He's the one who dreamt of making Bengaluru like Singapore when he was the chief minister. So what is the reason that his son-in-law is being targeted? Also, there are some murmurs going around that probably there has been a fallout between the father-in-law and the son-in-law. But these are just speculations that are doing the rounds, and we don't really have any concrete information to back it up, Karthikeya.
Thank you, Nishchita, for this update. My colleague Nishchita telling us that this story is not only about traits. You know, there is a political undercurrent to this story. There will be There will be economic overtones to the story, but the fact of the matter is that this will have its own impact in the politics of Karnataka.